Hello, welcome to the Freak Show. It's time for another Tale from the Potato League. We're no longer doing episodes, guys. It's just a Tale from the Potato League. I'll still number them, but I don't even know what's going on. Anyway, it's a podcast by Mutanot and Bumpy. Mutanot, hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello, indeed. All right, so we have Nature's Prophet against a bunch of invisible individuals.
Stone Cold Stunner.
That's right.
That's you.
And the Sheo. And the Dark Lord, who apparently is a king. And he's playing your Skywrath Mage. He is one of your favorites.
Yes, I miss him. I don't play him enough.
So did you get all your predictions in last night for the Shanghai Major?
Nope. I'm like the only person who doesn't have it, apparently.
Well, you are a shameful individual, and I just cracked two knuckles, and it was loud.
I'm a Shanghai...
reject. Shameful? You are a non-North American reject.
There you go.
That is shameful.
Let's see. Number one gun. Oh.
I wish they wouldn't do random draft. Why don't they just do all pick? It drives me nuts. Whatever. Drag it out, make it go slower than ever before. Why?
They're like, we don't want to give away our valuable picks. Otherwise, Cumstone will totally counterpick them.
With Mech runes and Mech runes Dagon. Dot Dagon? I guess it could be a sure, or Dagon. Prefer. Leech. So they have a double... I kind of wish we knew what hero pool they were choosing from, you know? That would be a nice added feature. Hint, 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 Valve.
That would be pretty cool, actually. Show you which ones are blacked out.
Yeah, like which ones are available or which ones are blacked out or what or something, you know? Like maybe it shows us if we were like hosting
coaching.
Do that with coaching too, probably. But I'm thinking, what would it show us if we were in a custom lobby and we had like two teams of five going at it? And we were actually doing the broadcasting? Maybe. But
maybe.
I'm not sure.
You ever notice how giant Warlock's nose is? What's going on with that thing?
It is pretty large.
I bet he's got huge ears, too. Old man ears. Gross ones with hair coming out.
I don't know, but he doesn't seem to be able to grow upper lip hair there, so... He's just got the weird beard with no mustache.
That might be a stylistic choice.
I don't know. He's got kind of like slitted eyes, too.
Or Gyrocopter stole it all.
What he had? That's possible, too. What happened to his nose other than it just being massively huge? There's like extra lines and things in there. It seems rather abnormal, I would say. Speaking of no noses, I think he's got Prophet's nose as well as his own.
Could be. I got your nose, Prophet, and Lich's. You got Lich's nose.
Yeah, well, Lich is kind of decayed a little bit.
Yeah.
But Prophet just doesn't seem to have one. Lich's Prophet's like, I don't smell anything. Literally, ever. I have no nose. I can't. It's
that's why he does so well with the... Oh, jeez.
Wow. Speaking of flat, smushed noses, what is that? Bloodseeker? It looks like he does have a nose. Maybe. It's hard to tell, though. That just could be his upper lip.
Entros going carry.
This is what this has devolved into, by the way, guys. We're just randomly looking at portraits at this point.
Well, they're taking forever and a mother to pick their heroes here.
That's right, and pretty soon there's going to be a baby on the way, and then what are we going to do?
That's the problem with random draft, is it drags out the whole picking process.
Can you imagine if this was Captain's Draft? I would just leave. Or a Captain's Mode, I would just leave. I'd be like, nope. Hey, it's the Trail Wall. Alright, so they're going to go all carries. That's cool. And Warlock, who could technically also be a carry if you send him mid. Which, we know that Commissar's not going to be going mid. Alright, I shall go over the Dire side as I slowly float my way up there. On the Dire side, we have CS GAC 237 rocking the Troll Warlord. Number one gun playing the Gyrocopter. Antros on Lifestealer. We have Dexter playing the Nature's Prophet. And we have Commissar looking at his little fiery bird of doom there as a courier. Is that like a dragon bird? I don't know. Anyway, he is playing the Vorlock. Did I miss anyone? No? And there's a random ward lane on the ground as well. Let's see, Nature's Prophet. Oh, good. If you thought it was bad when Nature's Prophets teleport first, this one decided to go sprout first because that's not the worst thing ever. That's worse than even going teleport first.
Yeah, that's...
Especially as an off-laner. Like, why? How would this ever be good? And why would you ever get a Soul Ring recipe? Or a soul ring on Nature's Prophet. Oh, my soul is bleeding again. Alright, go over the Radiant. Can't be any worse than the Dire.
Now, on Bounty Hunter is being played by the human Shao. Lich is being played by Mehrunes Dagon. Bloodseeker is being played by Cumstone. Lishrak is a Stoled Cold Stunner, and Skyrath Mage is a King Dark Lord.
We almost died to the Eurocopter.
Seems redundant. I gotta tell you, the Radiance is incredibly squishy.
Yep.
They
don't
definitely
have a carry.
Not really. They've got damage in spades, but I'm pretty sure they're gonna lose unless the Dire just really throws it.
I don't know. We've seen our boys. We know what they're capable of.
Oh, all right, yeah.
So you like the Skyrath versus Gyro mid. Alright, first last hit, Gyrocopter, who's just getting spammed out.
Yeah, but Skyrath will burn through his mana. Nope. He should really wait till level 3 before he starts.
He's faring a clarity out to himself. That's just sad. Okay, that's fine. Alright, meanwhile, top lane. Commissar blocked the pool camp there. He's walking over to aggro creeps and walk away and do nothing. Now he's going to get attacked by the Bounty Hunter, more than likely. Yep, there it is. And Troll Warlord randomly threw his whirling axes out. There's a heal going out onto Bounty Hunter. Not a lot going on there. Meanwhile, bottom lane. What a lane.
That Prophet, you know, in case Lishrak stuns him, he needs to be able to throw up his tree so they don't see him cry.
Don't see him cry. Meanwhile, in the jungle, Antros is jungling.
Well, I mean, with Gak on Troll Warlord here, where else was he to go?
I don't know. I think I might have... I don't know. Maybe even running him off lane's okay. Go off lane, start with the Iron
Although,
Talon.
Honestly, why not have...
Prophet jungle?
Yeah, agreed.
Well, Prophet's a ranged hero. He can maybe get some last hits and stay alive. He's up against a melee and a ranged. I mean, honestly, if this was... I don't know.
So how long before we have Invis Wards for Bounty Hunter?
I'd say at least the 15-minute mark. What say you? Okay.
I think maybe our guys learned something. I think 10 minutes, they get it.
10 minutes. All right, well, they're diving under tower. And there's a big hit onto Gak, and there's a heal out from Commissar, who's actually utilizing his mana pretty well so far. I don't hate it. Meanwhile, mid lane is getting completely destroyed by...
Look at there. What's in the stash?
Oh, did Commissar just buy it?
Invis wards.
Yeah, see? Commissar proving me wrong. Nice. I like to see that. I'd rather be proven wrong than right in situations like this.
Oh, Skyrath got a regen rune. That's just nasty. That's nasty.
Disappointing. And he got a rune, and his bottle is back at base.
It's coming to him. He better be careful.
Skyrath could two-shot him pretty easily.
Yeah, he could take a dump on him. And with Bloodseeker vision,
yep.
He can get his slow off from really far away.
Yeah, no fogging either. Here he goes. He's going to die for it. Oh, he's going to die for it, though, too. He's dead. Just turn around. Why are you not turning around? Oh, my God. What an idiot. But, like, if he would have done anything there, he could have gotten the kill. That's... Well, they already got first blood, I suppose.
The Skyrath, like, I'll run back.
It was already too late. He wouldn't have gotten away either way. But I don't know why he dove so hard.
I don't know why at that point he just... Commit 100%.
I don't know why he's tanking the creep wave there. That guy's... He's gonna die when Skyrath comes back, maybe. Meanwhile, bottom lane, or top lane, Gak is getting wrecked by the ridiculous amounts of slow coming out from the Bounty Hunter and the Lich. But there is...
Well, if that courier ever brings the Invis Wards, they can kill Bounty Hunter, I think.
Maybe. And he just broke his salve. I don't know why he would even have tried that. Wow, he just did the whirling axes nowhere near anyone. That wasn't good.
He won't have mana, but he'll be... Meanwhile, let's
Commissar
see. Prophet.
No mana either.
9 last hits!
Antros is farming the jungle. He's almost at the top of the CS board. He's going... I'm assuming treads, or is he going Midas, or what?
Oh, he's got 2 points in Sprout.
That's really weird. And he doesn't have any in his treants. Like, I don't know. I mean, I guess if we can commit to this weird, he's sitting still.
3 points.
Why would you not Oh my gosh! Like, you never need more than 1 point up in Sprout. Really, Gyrocopter killed Lishrak? Oh yeah, he rotated it in. Totally didn't see him. It's with the DD rune.
Neither did Lishrak.
Yeah, it is DD rune. How did he not channel his? Like, his move was going, right?
Yeah, the line of sight messed it up.
Why would he see how far away he just was when he popped that? That was so ridiculous. I don't know. It's fine. Well, First Blood went to Gyrocopter either way, even though he kind of failed the first Blood attempt.
Good news is Prophet can lock down someone for 5 seconds.
Like, you don't need Sprout more than 3 seconds at the early levels, you know? No. Agreed. Like, teleportation. 20-second cooldown to get anywhere on the map? Are you kidding me? That's, like, the greatest thing in the entire universe. Also, he's not buying anything. He's got 1,100 gold, and he's still sitting on a Soul Ring recipe.
Saving up for Radiance.
Saving up for... No, he's going to go straight Rapiers. That's fine.
The only thing that makes sense.
Sprout Rapier. That's it.
Oh, look at that. Yeah, you're not... Take a timeout, Lestrak.
Who could totally stun his way out of that, but, you know, it's fine.
It wasn't worth wasting the mana.
Meanwhile, yeah, Andros is going to be going the treads. That's fine. He's jungling efficiently enough, so that's good. I still think if he's going to be jungling like this, he should just get the Iron Talon. There's a really cool interaction with the Iron Talon with Open Wounds. If you get really low, you pop Open Wounds, you use the Iron Talon on a full health creep, you actually heal for that damage, because it's actually damage done, whether it's by spells or whatever the case is, that heals you. That's why Open Wounds is such an amazing skill. So as such, he could jungle even more efficiently if he just, like I said, he went and started with the Iron Talon.
So, Commissar still has the wards in his stash.
Yep.
Now they're on the
might,
courier.
Yeah, I think you might finally be able to get it. It's gonna head back to Antros, drop off, Antros to drop off his boots, and then it's gonna head to Commissar. Okay.
Wow.
Meanwhile,
Prophet actually put a point in his ult. I thought maybe he's just gonna go the 4-1.
He's gonna go 4-1 stats. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the new meta. Maximize.
What
that
else makes
damage.
Sense at this point?
Maximize the damage of the Rapiers.
Oh, dead Gyrocopter.
Yeah, Gyro didn't survive. That was an ult used. What's the cooldown on the ult? 60 seconds? No, it was used earlier then. Or something.
It got him weak enough that he risked for the rune dive, which...
It's risky, especially with the silence as well. He's got 1 point up his Ancient Seal. You approve of the 4-1-1 build, right?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I honestly don't generally build the 4-1-1 myself. I usually go 3-1-2-1.
So 3-1-2. Yeah.
Yeah. I generally after I have 3 in Arcane, then I start.
He just no Commissar. Why? You attacked as soon as you saw him. See, even getting the ward up there isn't as useful as you think it is, because there's literally no lockdown on their side of the map. So even if Bounty Hunter is seen, they could just kill him. Like, it's not as cool as you might think, unless Prophet came in.
Now, I was going to Skyrat to just stand there.
I didn't even notice he was getting killed there.
He just stood in the ult for the whole duration, pretty much.
Maybe he was baiting him in for that amazing rotation for Bloodseeker that is never going to happen.
It can be hard to smack your Ancient Seal on the Arcane Bolt, but you really want to start maxing that out once you hit your ult.
Ancient Prophet just killed Bounty Hunter.
Because the end is ruined.
No, it has nothing to do with it. He was down by his tower. He just got really weak. Maybe he got weakened by the Invis.
Yeah.
Oh, the sentry's just outside of range of their sentry. Well, that's a good placement, I guess.
Pretty sure Bounty Hunter was up top, and it was just a matter of...
If you double-click his body... Well, you can't now. He was right by his tower, right where he's teleporting in. That's where he died. Oh, they're dead. Oh, no, it bounced! Oh, now they're dead.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Oh, Commissar, no.
Thankfully, Lich doesn't have the mana for... Oh.
Oh, Commissar, what
now
are you doing?
Dead.
Why? You just kept walking. You would have been fine.
What the heck?
That is Entrance inside the dragon. He's not doing
dragon?
Anything. Yeah, he just could kill these guys, and he's just doing weird stuff. Like, he could have actually dove and killed Lich, no problem. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. I don't know what Bounty Hunter's thinking. Well, I do now. I can't believe he did that. That was so bad. Well, it was almost good, and then it was terrible. So.
Lich was really weak.
Like, he could have just went down there and killed him. No problem whatsoever. Also, I don't know why he would have raged instead of using open wounds there. That made no sense either.
Bountiful.
Whatever. I imagine he probably doesn't play a lot of Lifestealer. Lifestealer is a hero that's kind of right now, so... They did manage to take the top tower, that's good. And they are up 3-5, and I think they probably have, what, like a 2,000 gold advantage? Yeah, about 2,000 gold advantage going their way. But once Track comes online, which it actually is now, he is level 6, that's going to start changing things. I don't know why he has a ring of health, though. That makes me kind of nervous to see a ring of health up on a Bounty Hunter. Do you think he's going to go Battle Fury on the Bounty Hunter? Oh, Prophet's dead. He could have just TP'd out if he had a TP scroll, but he doesn't, so...
No, not Battle Fury.
Why are you running, dude? Just don't give it to Bloodseeker, give it to Lashrak, you moron. Like, you don't want to feed the Bloodseeker. At all.
I bet he goes Aether Lens. I don't know.
maybe. He wants to be able to track from the fountain, I guess.
You know, it's actually... If you get enough tracks out, being able to chuck that Shuriken and bounce across everybody...
From 700,000 range? Yeah, that's... Wow, that was a hopeful with a haste rune up.
A better choice than Battle Fury.
Oh, he's not dead because Gyro just decided to dive into him. And now Gak is going to die for him. Oh, you missed chance. No, don't go back in. You're going to live if you're not foolish. Good. Good heal, Commissar. Good heal.
My goodness, your boy Antros is obsessed with controlling ancients.
It's a really good thing, especially early in the game, to actually do, so I can't say it's bad, though. That's not one of the ancients you really want. Let's think about it. How hard is it for a level 5 or 6 person to kill an ancient that's not somebody like a TA? It's not the easiest thing in the world to do, so you can push down towers, you can chase people down. Troll just killed Bloodseeker and Lashrak. And survived. Oh my god, he's gonna die. He died. if they just grouped up around him, maybe the... I can't recall. It does target somebody specifically, right? The Diabolic Edict?
Yes.
So if they targeted... If they all grouped around him, maybe it wouldn't have just hit him only. So Prophet basically got him killed there. If he had Treants, he could have used that as well. Okay, okay. So, if you were ever to go Soul Ring... As Nature's Prophet, you would do it so you Radiant's could spam out your trees and everything else, right?
Yeah.
So why would you max Sprout and then get a Soul Ring? Like, it doesn't make any sense at all. Radiant's also, why does he have a Ring of Health? Attack. Is he going Lincoln's? Maybe that's what Bounty Hunter's going to Lincoln's.
Yeah, I don't know. About the only thing I could think of that would make sense be to max your trees would be why you want a Soul Ring. Just for early game.
I don't like this much. Oh, he waited so long for it, but he might get the... Yeah, he got the kill. Bounty Hunter's in there. Oh, he just revealed himself, and then Gak just let him walk away. He could have just gone melee Whirling Axes and killed him instantaneously, but he chose not to.
Oh, 2 for 2, but Lich's ult is up now, so they better be careful.
It's not great. Oh, gosh. And here comes a super ridiculously dead... Dire's middle tower. Maybe... I don't... Yep, he's dead. And gone. It's like they just don't have brains in their head sometimes. Like, why would you stay that weak near an enemy tower when you know there's a bounty hunter staying around? Even if you didn't know he was staying there, he could be. Oh gosh, they're about to get killed by the tower now. Oh my gosh. Alt, Lich! It's a guaranteed kill. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, it was only one person. I don't fault him for not doing it.
I would've. It was him and one creep. That's a guaranteed kill on the enemy
Look,
carry.
He stayed. It's still time for a kill.
Yeah, but that's a guaranteed kill on a carry. You don't just give that up for no reason. Like, that's pretty dumb. Like, super dumb, you know? Is he going to walk into... Oh, I thought he was going to walk into Bloodseeker. Bloodseeker's ult is up. He's just going to casually farm. Wow, he's really going to get away with it. It's crazy. Meanwhile, Antros...
Commissar's going to die middle, maybe.
Antros has still been a part of zero everything. He's only got 55 last hits at 13 minutes in. It's not great, considering he's jungled almost the whole time. However, he did stop to do some weird pushing. Some poor pushing with the Ancients, I guess. And he didn't even kill the Ancients off, therefore...
Oh, that's a dead
there.
Prophet if he doesn't just TP. Just TP back, dude. There you go. Yeah, no, the Shuriken.
He didn't throw
it. Oh, wow.
Why? He had the range.
I know he did. I don't know why he didn't throw it.
That was weird. Oh, and then Anchos didn't even stack. He walked right up at the stack time, and he didn't even try to stack it. That's weird.
I like how this Bloodseeker's just like, "Alt be darned, I'm going in!"
And dead. But that wasn't a track kill. Why wouldn't you track that and get the bonus goal? Oh my gosh, this Bounty Hunter. He's wrecking... He is going Battle Fury, I think. Or he's going crit. I don't know, he's got an extra weird Blades of Attack, so... Could be going crit, he could be going Battle Fury, he could be just randomly buying items he sees and thinks look cool, I don't know.
Yeah, it almost looks like he's going Crystallis.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He could be going crit, or he could be going Battle Fury. It really
Which
depends.
Which is strange since he already has Janata, but you know.
Yeah. But, you know, logic. What's that all about? You could rage off the track, Antros. Wow, that was a delayed damage hit there.
Yeah. First I'm like, did it uphill miss? I don't...
Yeah, I was a little confused too. I'm like...
Hawa?
Did he hit a creep? Like... Hmm. There's the heal coming from Commissar. Commissar is ready to go.
There's
drop
that
the
lich
bomb.
All.
Here it comes. He's dropping the golem. And
oh.
That is a... Hey,
and
the
they
sprout.
Got lucky. There
the
was
sprout.
Not...
Hop inside the creep! Hop inside the creep! Oh no, you raged! Why? You could have killed them both! Oh man, Antros, you make me so sad sometimes, buddy. It's alright, you were panicking. I can understand the panic. Like, if you just went into a creep and burst out immediately, he would have guaranteed killed Lich. And then they would have still killed Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, they got lucky on those Lich ult bounces.
Yeah, I didn't even see the Lich ult go off.
It only bounced one time
from
its initial target.
Was it Antros?
I don't even remember.
Oh, that's a pretty good creep. Except he went in the... I think he went in the right one. Yeah, he did. Like, except he went in the wrong one. That's really good for your team, though. It's not great for you. The one you always want when you're doing this is the Black Dragon. Because the Black Dragon has the fire that he can throw down. I think it's 5 times. And he can split push with it. He's got his armlet on, which is a bit weird. But it didn't matter. He healed up out of it. Not a big deal. Some freebie gold. Let's take a look how far ahead the Dire are. The Radiant brought it almost back to zero, and then now they're up 3,000 again for the Potato Leaguers. Gak is walking around with a Helm of the Dominator and some phase boots. He's got his creep over there to stack it up. And his creep's about to die at about 47 swings from this guy, and Gak misses. That's not great. And Sentry Ward? Sentry Ward? Sentry Ward? No? Yes? No, I thought they had it. Like, Commissar came over, I figured they had the sentry there, but apparently not.
Oh, they missed the stack.
Lich is there. They did
8 seconds
stack.
For his ult.
And I think Gak is done. There's a haste rune up there. The heal goes out, here comes the Lich ult. Maybe? Yes? No? No? Maybe? Yes? No? Nope.
I think they can get them both without it.
They probably can.
What?!
What are y'all?
Warlock by himself?
Wow. Well, they did get them both, but Lich did ult. What is Antros thinking going in against our whole team?
He's got backup, kind of.
Not really. Oh god, he walked right back into that. Wow, that could have been worse. That was awful. And here comes the level 1 missile that does zero damage, and everybody's fine. Meanwhile, Prophet, nowhere to be found, is back in base, building a Battle Fury.
Dire's middle tower
Lord,
what? Is
under attack. Why? Why is this a thing? He's building a Battle Fury. Or he's building a crit and Lincoln's Sphere at the same time? All he's missing right now is the broadsword.
Dire's
I mean,
tower
it's a thing. He went crit. Okay, I'm like. Oh, you know what I bet it is? I bet he went with the old casual Ring of Health for just health regen instead of getting the Tranquil Boots because you're invisible walking around most of the time. It's far more efficient. However, you do get more damage out of your phase boots. Efficiency-wise, Tranquils are way, way better.
Yeah.
I think they just brought it back to zero again, didn't they? Oh, no, they just brought it back by about 1,000. Here comes... I don't know what kind of initiation they're going to go on here.
Elastrak's super weak, that's for sure.
Yeah, he's backing up.
They should be pretty safe. Lich is all just down for a while.
Well, I mean, Bounty Hunter was scouting them, but he just kind of left. He's not scouting anymore, I don't... There is a Sentry Ward down, so they will see him. Oh, they're amidst... Oh, no, they're in the worst possible spot for this... Oh, Gak.
Darn Mother Nature.
Gak is 100% dead. I don't know what in the world they were thinking of going into trees there. That was a really bad idea. And they can't even... Nature's Prophet sprouts his own teammate. Let's Bounty Hunter get away. And then finally... Eventually, here comes... Oh, gosh. Oh, this is so bad. And there's the Lich ult, and yeah, they're 100% dead. That couldn't have... Like, you couldn't have paid me to, like, purposely do that worse than what just happened there. That was so bad. Meanwhile, Gyrocopter, chilling in the jungles, like, nope, I'm taking no
part of
that.
It's like, you know there's a bounty hunter scouting you, so why are you hiding in that little cluster of trees like he doesn't know you're there?
Well, it wasn't even a bounty hunter that found him, either. They ran right into Bloodseeker, and then they're stuck in the middle of the trees with a giant Bloodseeker to silence. There's no way you can get out of it. I mean, Ancho's played the right, did the right move by doing the rage, but there's no way Gak was going to get out of there with Troll Warlord. I mean, he doesn't have a
bounty hunter has completed the Perseverance.
I think Gak is going to be going Shadow Blade. Really? When a BKB is on the table, you're going to go Shadow Blade. Please don't. Please. Oh, thank God he didn't do it. I thought 100% for sure stupid Gyrocopter was going to sit there and try to go on the bounty hunter there, but he didn't.
All right. Bounty Hunter and Prophet had the same person buying their items.
I think so, too. And here we are. We're about 2,000 ahead for the Radiant. So, remember the almost impossible to throw? Well,
I still think they have it long game unless they...
Maybe, but they're...
Here's a Bloodseeker kill.
They're getting wrecked pretty badly. Antros is being chased by Bounty Hunter? How is that a thing? Dexter, nope. Ooh, Gyrocopter just got a kill on...
Bloodseeker, yep. He had Envis rune.
I thought Bloodseeker was going to kill him. But I didn't actually see it. Alright, the stack didn't happen again. It's still sitting there. Alright, still, there's a Bounty Hunter top. And still hitting Nontros.
Oh, good. We have some cock and balls.
Nice. Lovely. And Nontros is still getting wrecked by Bounty Hunter. There we go. There's some dust. Oh, and the rage is out. Oh my gosh, it's so good. And then Gak completely threw the axes nowhere near his opponent at all, not even sort of close in any way. He's like, hey, Antros, here, catch my axes, and then throw them back at the actual target. Oh, the Sprout!
Silence him! Sprout! Oh, you could have silenced them, buddy.
No, he couldn't. It was still uncle, though. I thought. Oh, maybe not.
He just
sealed it up. Oh, he just sealed it, yeah. There we go. That's why you max Sprout, ladies and gentlemen, for that ridiculously long Sprout there that he needed to get that kill. Had he maxed his teleport, he could have been there earlier. And he could already be back across the map right now, split pushing or doing anything useful. Never max Sprout, guys. Like, you can after you max your other skills, but never max it first, ever, under any circumstances. It is not a good idea. Did he miss? Well, Gak's dead again.
Lich alt.
He doesn't need alt.
Nope, okay.
Gak could run and they were all hurt. I don't know why they keep pushing into like all five heroes or four heroes with nobody else there.
It's only three.
There's four. There's four there now. It's still two.
Lishrak has his axe.
Yeah, that was Bloodseeker, Lich, Lishrak, and Bounty Hunter. They were all there. They just like walked in by. Oh gosh, they're gonna go for the backstab? This is not a good idea. There's a centaur. They're going to try to kill it. Did he actually stun or no? Oh! Commissar with the big blaze! Oh no! Oh no, the Lich ult! Oh no, Commissar, why? Oh, it's so bad.
Still, the engagement went pretty good.
It went amazing. That was like the perfect dream combo there, but...
They both have really good AoE.
That was just disappointing that they died like that, or that Commissar died like that with the Lich ult the last second.
With Gyro and Warlock combined, they can do some serious damage.
Plus, Nature's Prophet thing bouncing through, and like the random whirling axes and whatnot from Gak, plus Gyrocopter, not just his ult, but his flat cannon too. Getting those shots out a little bit quicker.
Just yules yourself, Skywrath.
Alright, so did Prophet actually go Battle Fury, or we just don't know, he's not there yet? He needs to get 300 more. How does he not have 300 more gold? He's been waiting forever to get this item.
He's been waiting, or you've been waiting?
He's been trying to get it forever, and he still hasn't. He's getting no farm. He's not going to a lane. He's got one point up in his treant. Like, what is this dude? Look, now he's just sitting in the middle of the.
Gak is also going Battle Fury.
I hate that item on Troll as well, but. At least it makes slightly more sense than on Prophet. It's a terrible item on Troll, though. Absolutely 100% garbage. Never, ever go for that, guys. If you're going to play Troll Warlord, do not go for it. I thought for sure with the Broadsword he was going to go for the Shadow Blade. Didn't like it, but I like it way better than I like the
Bounty Hunter's almost certainly going Battle Fury.
Antros could have teleported out, but that would require him having a TP scroll. which he didn't have. Bounty Hunter's going what?
Battle Fury.
Yep, yeah, he is. See, even on Bounty Hunter, it's a better item than it is on Troll. I suppose if you're going to run around as a melee hero all the time, it's fine, but I mean, I'd say you split off quite a bit. You're on and off between melee and ranged quite frequently. You want to farm a wave and with relative safety, or... Well, you got a... Oh, gosh. The bounce, he turned back into it, and he got a kill. And now, Commissar... Oh, gosh, Dexter, no, not like this.
Not like this.
And Commissar, a little soul survivor, slowly building toward the mech. Yeah, this is over. Pretty sure.
I gotta say, honestly, it's actually been a pretty even back and forth game. You had a huge Dire spike where they were up like 3k, then the Radiant was up 3k, then it evened out again, and now the Radiant's up 3k. Like, it's, if you look, it's been jumping back and forth for the last 10 minutes.
Yeah. Well, here's the big problem. It doesn't seem like Bounty Hunter is actually tracking people for when they go to get the kills. If he had like 4 or 5 more track kills, they would be up like over 10k by now, I think. Because most of the kills that are getting are pickoffs with like 3 or 4 people there. Remember, the more people around, sure, it splits the other gold, but you get more out of the track that way. So, you know, you can get like an additional 150 if Bounty Hunter's there, or you get an additional like 500 if all of the, you know, the entire team is there, so... You decide what's better. Alright, and then there's this giant golem. He's just wandering around. He's like, yep. I'm a giant golem. I don't care who knows it.
Increases the health capacity of nearby allies.
Yeah, it's a really good one for your team. It's not really great for your, not really great for you yourself. Oh, he got it before the ult went off. Oh, no. Oh, the split.
Oh, they did it.
Went good. Oh, they might even be able to kill... Yep, they got him. All right, we'll track's down, and now the reveal. Oh, he's under a sentry ward too. Oh no, what? Kill him? No, he just ate it, and he's out. Does he actually have the Battle Fury too? No, not yet. Okay, he's gonna get away. No, no, why?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, this Nature's Prophet should just shoot himself in the face. What in the world was that?
You know what's funny? Elantros just messaged me like 60 seconds ago that he's raging because this prophet sprouts.
Yes,
and I'm like,
I don't blame
wonder what he's... Oh, I know what he's talking about now. I agree, Antros. I agree.
Yep, Antros, that was not nice, man. You had that kill 100%. Or at least there was like a 90% chance you had it. Maybe,
oh, man, he better be careful.
Low. I think he's going to go down here. Like, there's a track at least. That's good. But seriously,
don't. You're going to get Janata'd.
No, what are you doing? No! He was typing to you right there. I bet that's what he was doing. I bet he was typing to you about the sprout.
Could be.
And there's the Bounty Hunter Battle Fury at 28 minutes in. Oh my gosh, this Nature's Prophet is just the worst I think I've ever seen. I can't... Like, we've had some bad Nature's Prophets, but... I don't know,
no,
this guy no, is...
No, that was what happened, Antros.
That was pretty bad. Like, seriously. That's
he knew he was
time.
Tracked.
Yeah. Well, no, I don't think he knew he was tracked because he was running and then he just stopped. So maybe he was running over there, he stopped to type, and then he went to go back in and use the. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Wow, Gax just got obliterated.
Was that Yule Scepter alt, baby?
This is.
Yule
Scepter. Is that what he did, really? Oh, God, I bet he did, too. It looks like it. Well, actually, no, because Yule's is off cooldown. I don't know why people get Yules on the hero. Here's why you don't go Battle Fury or whatever it is you're trying to go. I guess that's what you're trying to go. Yeah.
Oh, look
you
at Blitz.
You need the BKB before Troll is useful. Without the BKB, you're just going to get kited and you're not going to be able to do anything. If you have the BKB, you can do whatever you want. Oh, he's dead. Oh, no, he's not. Okay. The heal was just enough. Antro's about to get slapped upside the... Oh, he's going to get tracked and then hit with some lightning. No big deal. This is a crazy, crazy game, but I'm pretty sure the Dire are too far behind now to recover. The itemization of the choices and Nature's Prophet have really, 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 really put them... Oh, gosh! Oh, that's a disaster. Oh, but they didn't follow through on it. Oh, here it comes.
What?
How did that not bounce? Kyler was almost hugging him at the time.
Prophet just, like, absorbed it in his coat? I don't...
He's just like, ooh, nose. Wait, no, that's not a nose. Never mind. I don't know what happened to it. Yeah, you know, looking at him now, he looks like he kind of has a nose if you look at his portrait.
Oh, jeez.
That's
because you're staring up at...
He's staring up his nose. You can see his brain. Wait, it's hollow. It's empty. There's nothing in there. This is a funny game. Well, they still can win, but man, they're going to have to not be terrible for a little while.
Honestly, yeah. At least he has Ags. That was a very lucky bounce they got. He's not bouncing at all, and he's almost got refreshers.
Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh, no, Gak. Why? Oh, and then the Glimmer Cape just wrecked everybody. Oh, no. And another Sprout!
Once Lich has refreshers, it's over.
Oh, my gosh. Antros is probably wanting to murder... Honestly, Andros, this shouldn't be that big of a deal to you because you really, really, really... You have a Quelling Blade. Why didn't you use it? Anyway, it shouldn't be that big of a deal to you because you should have started with an Iron Talon. It would have accelerated your jungle farm significantly. But still, you have the Quelling Blade, so there's even less of a reason for that to be a problem. Oh, and he's even having to buy dust. Oh, man. Oh, hey, what? They just, like, passed each other and... Oh, wait, here comes Bounty Hunter going after Prophet. They see him. The dust is not there yet. But the bomb is coming out, and it's going to hit him. He uses phase boots to try to get away. Not gonna be enough. All right, you sprouted him, and he's just gonna go invisible again. Oh, never mind, he's done. Wow,
that looked pretty impressive.
Was it on cooldown? I don't think so. Like I just
it's like down. Nuked those trees.
Yeah, I know. Aha! I mortared your grave. There's nothing left. Leveled an entire forest. Don't you think that should kill trees, too? Whoa.
Whoa.
Some random laughing. What was that about?
I don't know.
Some casual cackling, guys and gals. Who knew that would be
But Lich is 400 away from Refresher. Ags.
That's going to be pretty scary.
Well, I still have no idea how it didn't bounce last time.
Yeah, well, I mean, Warlock wasn't like within melee range, but he was still pretty close.
One good Lich ult and they're dead.
Yeah, they don't know how to delta split. They can get them right here. Easy kills.
It should.
Antros is running. Do your open wounds. Attack. Don't let them group up. Oh my god, are you kidding me? There, he finally ate through it. Now Gak's gonna die to the creeps. Nope. Prophet's gonna do it. Prophet, bring it in to the rest of the team. Gak's gonna die. Oh, what? I thought he said he had the axe.
He does, but he kept bouncing. It bounced a tree and it killed it, and it didn't have anything to bounce to after that.
Oh, they're going after Bloodseeker here, who's not ulting for some reason. Now he does, after the fact. Oh gosh, what is this team? Where is the team? What happened?
I have no idea how Prophet escaped.
Sorry, I was watching Antros, who again does. Oh, he does have a TP scroll. I'm like, he again doesn't have a TP scroll. It's so weird that he did. He didn't have mana for it, though. Actually,
wow.
He did, but he opened wounded again instead of just rage TP.
That's not great. If they can't win a fight with Lich gone.
Yeah, so what happened to Warlock and Gak? I mean, Gak was really weak, though. So I imagine he just...
I don't know about Gak, but Warlock was weak, and they nuked down Prophet, and he barely TP'd out.
Oh, that's nice. I'm so glad you left that one little baby creep there to maximize your farm. Good job, Gyrocopter. Also, where was Gyrocopter during all of that?
He's got to farm his... I don't know.
Like, this has been a problem with the games that we played lately, too. We never seem to be as five, yet we keep fighting 4-on-5, 3-on-5, 2-on-5, and we lose every time. And it seems like they're doing the same thing. They're always missing one person. And they go and they take fights, and they lose the fight. Like, I think if they had the full 5-on-5 fight, and they survived the Lich ult... they just profit. Oh my god, I love it. I think you're right. I think Bounty Hunter's playing both Prophet and Bounty Hunter, because he went and he built himself the Lincolns and he built himself the crit.
Yeah.
Oh, so bad. Like, why would you need a Lincoln Sphere? There's so many things that could break it. You have Blood Rage, you have Lich's Frost Blast, you have Track, you have...
Skywrath was born to break Lincoln's Fears.
Like, everything Skywrath has. You have Lightning from Lishrak. Oh, there's a fight going on somewhere. Good lane, and Antros is going to guarantee the kill. Prophet's probably going to sprout Antros now for no reason. Yak actually didn't take much damage.
I'd be careful. This Bounty Hunter is actually doing some serious damage.
Yeah, and Skywrath actually went down to Gyrocopter by himself, which is impressive. So, there's that. Oh, Bounty Hunter just bought a crit because of whatever reason.
Full Daedalus, baby.
He does a 225% guaranteed crit damage. Plus, he can also crit, I guess. 220. Just really?
He wants to be able to. Listen. He wants to be able to crit the other 5 seconds.
It'd be pretty funny if it stacked and he got like a 500% crit off of Janata plus the Daedalus. Oh, here they go. They're jumping on Stone Cold Stunner. He's going to use his. Oh, they dusted him. I don't know if that was necessary. He had no mana. He couldn't TP.
Well, this is awfully nice of the Radiant to let themselves get picked off one by one.
I know. This is the, what, third kill in a row? However, they are still split a little bit. The dire side, anyway. You have Gyrocopter, who's back at base. You have somebody who's
TP. Oh, Prophet's going up top.
He's going to get killed by Lich? Nah, maybe. I bet he would if Lich went at him. Like, this is literally the worst. I don't think there is a worse game that you could actually buy the Lincoln Spear in. Literally every hero has multiple ways. I don't know. Does Lishrak?
What were you thinking, Bounty Hunter?
Does Lishrak have more than one way to break the? Yeah, he's got the Yule Scepter as well. So yeah, every single hero actually has more than one way of actually destroying that. All right, here comes a big fight on.
Lich just wasted his ult. Oh my gosh, the Radiant just start falling apart.
Yeah, they are. Comes a stun, the big BKB to Gyrocopter, and the beatdown from Antros. And there's another sprout onto Antros. Oh my god. Oh no, the Lich ultimate!
He got Refresher. But thankfully, he wasted the first one.
Oh, he didn't. Oh my gosh, that bounce. It bounced into the creep wave where there were six other targets, and then it went to the farthest target, which was Gyro.
They're lucky. He had a horrible ult earlier, which is what allowed him to win that fight there in the jungle.
Bad now for the Radiant, but Dire could still throw this, and they very well may when the Sprout comes out from Prophet here. Nope. Not gonna happen, and the casual walk off. No big deal. No big deal. All of Antros' mana is gone, which is gonna Radiant's pretty much make him just a big melee attack. Creep at this point. Radiant's though he does still have the armlet, so maybe a little bit better than a melee creep. Oh, there was mana boots from... Yeah, from the good old Commissarian one. And now they're going to go for the all-in torch down mid. Do you think this leads them to their death? I think it's probably going to.
Could be, but they've got a...
Lich's ult's probably going to be up, and it's up now, actually. So all Lich has to do is walk up ult, and they're all dead if they get any kind of luck at all. Oh, they're going to actually lead the base and chase them. I don't know if that's the play, but... See, look, the Lincolns was popped by whatever, and they could easily get the kill, and I think they will. Prophet should die here. Antros is waiting. What are you thinking, buddy? Oh, you didn't even get your rage off, dude. What was that? Gak, no! Oh my goodness, Gak, run like the wind be- Oh, you're done. Ult? No? Who did Bloodseeker ult? Well, I don't know, it doesn't matter. He's super fast now. He's just gonna go and try to do murder here. Really, the silence, huh? See, well, I guess. Stop into it. And Commissar, if he gets seen. Nope. Yep, there you go. This is exactly what I was expecting. They were going to push up high ground. They were going to get chased down.
Lich didn't even ult.
I know. He was too far back, I think, the whole time.
They just got to do what they did before and get some pickoffs, I guess.
You think Lich is going to go Blink Dagger? I think he 100% should this game.
Seeing as how he hasn't bought anything, I think it's possible. Lich and... He's had a couple, but sometimes it happens. Lich and Lishrak have both been playing. Even Skywrath have been playing fairly solid.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, Gyro. Oh. Do they see him? Do they know? They don't know. But he's going to walk
you,
right
him and Bounty Hunter. Same buyer.
Nope. Not going to walk. Or not going to walk into the Lich. What, Nature's Prophet? Oh, he's got the Daedalus, too. But see, that's a normal item for Prophet, right?
It is, but it's just...
I still can't believe he bought Battle Fury, and then he left the Yasha. Oh gosh, that was our dive. He left the Yasha in his stash. Like, why would you not carry the Yasha with you? It's such a good item. The movement speed, everything else, Prophet's dead. And Antros is diving in, 1v4.
No, Gak is there, and Gyro.
Oh, Gyro showed up.
Gak, the whole team's
up.
Pretty much there.
Close, and the Lich ult is going to crush all of them. Gak, oh no, Gak sacrificed himself for the greater good there.
The greater good. Well, they only lost the tier 3 tower, so
The SOI is being slowly built up by Gak. Tier 3 tower for 4 kills, and how did Bloodseeker get away? He just ran at the beginning?
I guess. Antros going Axe, looks like.
Really? No, he's going to go Scotty. I can't see that being Axe.
He's got the point booster and the Ogre Club.
Oh, maybe. What does his Axe do? Let's see here. If infested, unit dies before Lifestealer consumes it, no health will be gained. Lifestealer gains experience while under the effects of infest. Groups that are controlled while infested share Lifestealer.
Well, look, adds the assimilate ability. He can swallow a target ally, allowing them to hide within him.
It's been so. I haven't even seen that. You know, that was what, like 6.81 or something, or 6.79. I've never actually seen that used ever in an actual game that I've watched or played. So yes, that's why I'm like, really? Axe? What's happening right now?
I mean, getting hurt so not bad? Terrible, maybe, to put Gyrocopter inside of him.
Oh, he doesn't have the TP. He could have jumped inside of him. Oh, with a cooldown. Dude, you're going to die in like 2 seconds if you don't get out of here. You're dead. Doesn't matter. It's too late. It's all over. Oh, and the Sprout block. Yes! Now Prophet's dead too. Oh my gosh, this guy is so bad. Look. Oh, he got a kill. That's the way he gets two, right? Oh, maybe he did. Oh, the Lich ult. And it's enough. Skywrath didn't die. Man, I thought for sure Skywrath was going to die there. Oh my gosh, let's show the fight recap here. That was a 6,206 exchange for XP and almost a 2,500 gold exchange for the Dire, or for the Radiant. So they're probably going to be about 5,000 ahead again.
Skywrath getting a Dagon.
And this is going absolutely insane. They need to finish this up, though. Because if they do not, the world will end. Like, I don't know. I don't know who it favors anymore at this point. Like, the items coming out for the Radiant are just crapping all over the Dire. The Dire have way, way, way more potential to grow, but they're not actually growing, so it's kind of rough. What happened to the SNY for Troll? Is it on the courier? Most of it is. Troll's trying to do Roshan very ineffectively. It looks like he's going to start getting it now. He's got his stacks up. What is that stuff called? It's been so long. Fervor.
The Fervor.
Yeah, he's got his Fervor stacks up, and he's doing some damage there. Oh, there's a Lich ulti onto Ancients. Oh, yes. The old Ancient play for when Antros walks over. Oh, God! Oh, God, run!
What's the purpose of that ult?
If you get two or three of those up and somebody walks over, it just murders them instantly. Because it will continue to bounce forever. So you can actually stack 3, 4, 5, 6 Lich ults on it. It'll continually bounce, and when somebody walks over, it'll just instantly kill them. Because it'll all jump on them at once.
Interesting.
I've seen it happen before. Never in a game again that I played, but I saw it on in a video. Just like I suppose I did see the Aghanim's upgrade for Lifestealer in a video as well. It was like the Storm Spirit into a bunch of other people.
So, interesting tactic, I guess.
Here we go. He just ate Gak. Who I think that was... I think he had Bloodseeker's ult on him. That's pretty interesting.
Can he eat Gak and hop inside of a creep?
Yes, he can. I think he might have to do it the other way first, though. Oh, God.
Uh-oh.
Commissar lives. There's a jump out. All of the Lich ults back out again.
There's two Lich ults. Antros absorbed them.
Antros, Gak, Antros, Gakros on... Did the Prophet have Aghs too now? Is that...
Jack died, but he came back because the Aegis.
This might be the all-in play that they needed to win it. They just outplayed the Radiant there with the tools that they had, but they don't have creeps. So they're wasting Troll ult and all. Oh, they didn't use it yet. My bad. It was Antros' rage that we saw there. All right, did Commissar even ult there? Yeah, he did. Okay. They're like, we don't even care about, I guess we'll kill him. He's there, might as well, he's stuck for like a day and a half. Now here's the cool thing, I don't know if you've seen this yet. If you get the Octarine Core on Prophet, you can actually permasprout people. Like, the cooldown and the cooldown and the duration are actually the exact same. That's really cool.
Well, they just needed Entros' rage to eat both Lich alts.
Yep. Well, the first one they split, but the second one was between Entros and Gak, and Entros absorbed it with the rage, and Gak actually got away, so worked out fantastically well. And now they just have to walk away and not die, and then victory will be theirs. I think number one gun might end up being dead here. Did he go Lincoln's too? No, he didn't. He's going Scotty, though. There's the troll ult going down bottom to get the mega creeps here. Entros, if they hug Entros or...
I don't know why Entros. They're all Lich and Lashrak are like, we don't know what we want to do.
They're going for broke. If they get this, they can win it. Gak, focus. Focus the rack, dude. Oh my god. Seriously, dude. If you just hit the racks three times, I almost wish they would lose because of that. I mean, it's bad to say, but... Like, how do you're gonna die anyway. Why get distracted and let them not get mega creeped? Like, seriously, that was game winning right there.
Here's the good news is they're gonna be distracted and not defend their base.
I don't think so. Like, Bloodseeker just owned Gyro because he's an idiot. And I think they can just all go down. Yeah, they're just pinging all down mid, skip over, and just go directly to the tier 4s.
They don't do it in time.
Oh, you know, there's three buybacks available too, so there is that. And
look at that super melee creep. That's randomly.
Where is this at?
Okay. He just walked into the middle and then disappeared without warps.
Prophet, what are you doing, buddy?
That's a pretty cool career.
What is he doing?
On the radiant side.
About to find out. He just teleported in the middle of the and he. Just... Really?
Winter. Have you seen the Radiant creep or career?
Yeah, the OD. Yeah, I saw
it. OD baby.
Yeah, baby OD. Well, they still have this. I mean, like I said, they all have buyback. It's not a big deal. The only one who didn't was Warlock. He's already back up. All they have to do is win the fight, though, and I think they have both Lich ultimates up. Skywrath obviously has his. He's got 8 Bloodstone charges. He's got a Dagon, which I don't know why. Instead of a Blink Dagger or Force Staff would have been much better. Force Staff for sure. I mean, they've got all the tools they need to win it, but can they? Where's Lich at? Lich
is they there. Will. Look, I'm telling you, they're going to let their last racks fall. Well, look at it right now.
I don't think that's going to matter. If they lose, if the Dire lose the fight right here, it's over. There's the first Lich ult. It's going to bounce amongst the creeps. All right. And that was pretty bad. You know, you want to do that once they're committed, not just randomly walk up and do it. Well, that's good, at least. So they started that. Oh, I thought he was going to Lich ult again. Now's the time you do it, though. Entros
has got the refresher.
Oh.
Good Commissar ult.
He's going to sacrifice himself to save. That's fine. Totally okay. Gak has gone in. Oh, no. He's standing underneath the... Here comes the call down from...
Lich didn't refresher himself. He could have ulted. He didn't.
Yeah, that was a mistake. And the barracks is still standing bottom. There's a Mjolnir up on Bloodseeker at this point. This is getting scary. But they're still pretty far ahead at this point, so. Yeah, if Lich would have just refreshed and ulted, that would have been completely different. He's also got the Octarine core up. I mean, I don't know why he didn't go Blink Dagger. I mean, do you really need to lower the cooldown of the Lich ult just a few seconds more? I don't feel like it's that useful. Still, 45 seconds is crazy, and then you can have two of them, but again, the refresher, like, here's the problem when you do something like this with the Octarine Core, right? The refresher still has a ridiculous long cooldown of 146 seconds, so you can still, you know, it doesn't make sense.
It does decrease the cooldown of the refresher use as well.
I know, but it's still not worth it, in my opinion. Ah, whatever. Alright, I don't believe he's going to be able to stand up to Entros without using his ulti. Which he should be using, which he's not using.
See, Andros being smart, he just made all end.
But they could have stopped that too. I don't know why they didn't just stop him there. He could have ulted. They also, I want to point out, did have the glyph up. They didn't use it.
What in the world? Talk about, like, the kiting.
Oh, gosh. Oh, the bash! He's bashing creeps, though. Does he even realize that he's doing this? Oh. What did he... Okay, I'm like, where did he jump? Oh, Prophet's dead. I'm sure Entros is not going to even think about stopping to save that guy. I was just like, yeah, I could maybe potentially save him, but nah. Alright, so maybe you do have to eat the guy and then you eat the creep. Let's see. Can he? No. Yeah, he has to eat the ally before jumping into a creep, I think. Alright, so he's running back in, and here comes the fight to end it. And there's the Lich ult, and they're not going to split. Oh, but he ate him! He ate him! That's actually really cool. I like that synergy. Antros with the big plays, carrying the team on his hunched over, half missing back, ladies and gentlemen.
Look at that spike down in the net worth. Really quick on that chart.
Oh my, that is a massive network change. Like 14,000?
Yeah, and just a matter of minutes.
And it's going to get worse and worse and worse. Well, they brought it back together. I'm very happy to see that. I'm also very happy to see Lifestealer actually being a hero again. It's been a long time since he's been a viable option. Very cool to see. Again, Battle Fury on... Don't do this, guys. That's not worth it. Like, I mean, maybe if you were farming for, like, a 75-minute game against, like, an anti-mage or something and you needed it, sure, but... Thompson's like, I want to have my golem out. I want to show my dominance. And there it is, folks. That is going to be the game. Any final thoughts, good sir?
Nope.
Just good game, and Nature Prophet sucks, right?
Bounty Hunter should stop buying for both of them.
I agree. Anyway, folks, that is going to do it for this particular episode and this week. We will be back next week with more. Or another tale.
I've got a final thought.
What? What's your final thought?
And you thought there's nothing you hated worse than a mountain farming prophet. You found it!
I did. Yes. So if you guys would rather go and farm the high ground with Nature's Prophet with teleport first, even that's better than getting Max Sprout or Sprout first. Anyway, guys, we'll see you next week.